welcome me back to our stage after too long an absence, Jean Carroll. So let's have a... back on the show again, and I want to congratulate you. You've taken off a lot of weight.
Yeah.
Your hair is different. Everything about you is different.
You really think so?
Uh-huh.
Wait till you hear the jokes.
Well, now, don't tell me you're going to be picking on your husband again.
Well, who do you want me to pick on, Alan King's wife?
No, but he's such a nice little guy. You people really should see him.
Who, my husband they should see? I should see my husband.
Oh, stop.
Do you mind if I do a little picking? See, I understand why Ed doesn't want me to pick on my husband, because I'm only joking. You know that. I got a husband, handsome, you'd never call him. But this guy, no, please, don't laugh, because he's the most wonderful man. He's always full of fun, he's always making jokes, he's laughing. Nothing bothers him. He drinks. I'm really not complaining, because he is easy. Like, I'll say to him, honey, don't you think you ought to have a little bite to eat? He says, sure. I say, what do you want? He says, make anything. I say, what do you want? He says, anything. I say, what kind of anything? Which anything? Because no matter what anything you make, it's not the anything he wanted. What do you want? Anything. Now I go to my kid, my rotten kid, and I say, honey, how about some food? She says, all right, I'll have a little something. I said, I'm not cooking two separate meals this afternoon. Your father's having anything, you'll have some of his anything. And another thing, I said, you know what? I'm a little tired of staying home. I don't mind it once in a while, but it's ridiculous. I go stir crazy. I'm beginning to wait for the warden to come in to shave my head. I'm home so much. I said, you know what? We'll eat out. My husband says, no. Not on a Sunday. I don't like crowds. Sunday's my day to relax. I'm in my pajamas. I don't want to shave. I said, don't shave. I'm calling for the car. He said, I don't want to dress. I said, don't dress. I've made the reservation. He said, I don't want to go. I said, don't go. I'll invite my family over for the day. 3 minutes later, we're in the car. We're going to the restaurant. Well, do you know, folks, that I think it's 2.5 million people eat out on a Sunday, and they were all in this restaurant when we got to it. And of course, you know, we get online, and my husband says to the head waiter, very nice fella, clean cut from ear to ear. And my husband says, say, whatever happened to our reservation? He says, I don't know, what tribe are you from? Well... we sit down at the table, and my husband takes off his coat. He says, what are you staring at me like that? What's the matter? You don't like my tie? I said, it's very nice, but it doesn't match your pajamas. Well, the waiter comes over, and he says, what's that green thing on the chair? I said, that's my husband. He's looking at the prices. Now, he says, all right, what do you want? Now, you know how these kids are. They're never hungry at home. Take them out, they'll stop. My daughter said, Mom, I'll have a whole broiled lobster stuffed with peanut butter and jelly on a bagel. The waiter said to me, what are you getting? I said, I'm getting nauseous. A whole broiled lobster stuffed with peanut butter on a bagel? Put mine on rye. Well, all I can tell you, folks, my husband looked at that menu and he said, I'll have Frankfurters and beans. I said, Frankfurters and beans in a fancy restaurant? This you could always eat at home. He said, good, let's go home. We'll eat Frankfurters and beans. It's nice being here.